DBT tags are another way to select particular models that you want to run. For example, down here in your run command, you can select certain models by tag. You can select seeds, snapshots, and you can even run tests. Like many other things, you can set your tags as a model config either in your DBT project or on the model specific level in the config block. So let's go through these examples one at a time. So here we are back in Visual Studio Code looking at our DBT project. And what we're going to do is first set that value in our DBT project file as a model config here. When we set this, what this will do is pass through to any model that fits that directory layer. For example, let's say we want just for this example directory, everything in here to be given a specific tag. What we can do here is let's add another layer for example. So this is saying we're going to add configurations for this directory. And within here, we'll use the plus sign to indicate that this is a configuration and the configuration name is tags. And the name of the tag we'll give, in this case, let's just say P1, priority one. And the way we can run this now to select this would be dbt run, use the dash M for model selection. And this time, instead of maybe putting one specific model name or a couple, what you can do is say tag colon and then the name of it. So we'll go P1. Notice that here it's called tags plural, and here you're saying reference this one tag. Let's go ahead and run this, and we would expect these four example models to run. And there it finished, and we can see it did run all four models, staging example, example, example. So that covered all of these. Now we only have one specific tag here, but what you could do is put this on another layer indent with a dash and make this a list. So maybe you want multiple tags. So you could add more than one, let's say another tag. And if we were to do the same thing and run another tag, we would get the same outcome because now each model has been tagged with both of these and this would fit this selection. And here we can see this ran successfully. And you can see now that you can add 1, 2, 3, however many you want, number of tags to any given configuration. So let's say you had some models that you either want to override, or maybe you just want to give a few models here and there a specific tag. You can set this in the config block within a model. So if you remember from other videos, it's just config. And then in here we could say the attribute is tags, and here instead of the colon, it'll be equals and it'll be a list. And one we'll give is, let's just say special tag. Now let's just try to run tag special, and we would expect this time to only run this particular model. We would only expect one, not all four. And here we can see one of one, it's running teams example, and that's it. Now, another interesting way that you could use tags outside of running models is also with testing models. You could go into any of these. Let's go to our schema here, and you can add a tag in a couple different places. Let's actually take a quick peek at the definition here. If you go to this tag property, so if we go back to the documentation, we can see there's different ways to use tags within models, sources, seeds, snapshots, etc. For this video, we're just focused on models. And if you scroll down, you can see there are ways to test using a tag. In this case, they're doing PII. They've given it to this column and it's going to test every model with that tag. So let's try that. If we go back in our project here and let's say we want our, let's do the second one. Why not? If we want to say, add another section here called tags, let's say test tag. Now this tag is associated with this column in this model. If you want to run the test command and just these, you would do dbt test dash M for model selection and tag test tag. It would only test this column in this model, and this column has two tests. So we should see two tests run. Let's see what happens. Here we can see one of two. It's running those two tests on my second model. And there you have it. It's picking this up and running those tests. The last thing I'll show you is kind of a bonus here. I want to show you how you can actually exclude running some things just by using tags. So let's say we wanted to run everything in the example directory, but not the teams one. So we want these three, but not teams. The way we could do that is dbt run dash m tag, and we can, you know, we can pick either of these. So let's just do p1 and then dash dash exclude, and this might be something new, and this is a way to determine which resources you want, and we're going to exclude tag special. So we would expect it to try to run everything, but it's going to also identify that this has a tag of special and not include it. So we would only see three of the four here. And let's see here, one of three. So that's a good sign. And we would not see example underscore teams. We see team details, first model, second model. So that worked exactly as expected. Hopefully this gave you a good insight on how tags work, and you can start to see how it can be a really powerful way to determine which resources and which models you want to run or test within your project. Thanks for watching.